Welcome to Analytics with Nags. This is another video in the Catch Up with Nags series where I'm going to discuss about Power BI release June 2022. 4 days back, the Power BI team has released what are the features available as part of June 2022. That is what we're going to discuss in this video. Without wasting time, let's begin our today's topic. If you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. So one of the key feature I like is connect to data maths, and I will talk about this in detail. What is this about data maths and whether you need to go for it or not? Those things maybe you can expect in next week. I will cover it in detail. Let's walk through this month update. So no format pane is generally available. Few months back it was in a preview. Now this is available as general audience, and you have error bars and information protection update, table navigation improvements. So basically Power BI team is coming up with lot of improvements in the table visual, because if you see earlier 1 year back, there are no more formatting options. Even ordering of between multiple columns is not possible. So but now they are continuously improving this table navigation. So now you can see what are the features it has gone through. So new keyword shortcuts for shift up and down, enhanced row selection experience. So you can see now you can able to select multiple rows. So those kind of stuffs they have improved a lot. Then canvas zoom in Teams and quick create, pretty much not sure, I've never used that feature. And one important thing about this is composite models for SQL Server analysis server. So earlier there is no composite. When the Power BI introduced a composite model, it is not available for SQL Server analysis service. But now you can see the composite model, Power BI models, by creating SQL Server 2022 analysis service tabular models. So it is available now for public preview, and when you upgrade and deploy your tabular models to 2022. So the one thing is you need to upgrade your existing SQL Server analysis service tabular model to your 2022 version. Once it is upgraded, then Power BI will support your this composite model, where you can connect to SQL Server analysis server as well as you can import some other tables from some other sources as well. That is what this composite model is all about. I hope this feature is required those who are using their on-premise SQL Server analyst service and they are waiting for long. As I said before, this data maths are something that is pretty much new, and there are pros and cons of using this data maths. So let me discuss this in a detailed video. What about it? To give you a quick overview, what is data math? Earlier we have data flows where you can pre-built your all your ETL or all your logics, right? Power Query logics, and store it in a cloud. That is, it is storing in Azure data lake storage. Now they introduced a data maths where you can build all your ETL logic. Either you can connect data flows or you can connect directly to the source. Then you can build your ETL logics, and then this data is stored in your Azure SQL database. And in turn, the data maths will create your data sets as well. So this is called a data mart. And when you need to go for data flows, data maths, those things I'll cover as part of my Power BI service playlist. That will come to that later. So this is one of the thing that is in a preview feature. Maybe in upcoming months, they will make it as generally available, and there are a lot of connector updates for different sources. Then announcing the data hub. So basically like data hubs. This you can see from here where you can get the data. Power BI data sets and data marts together considered as a data hub, where you can find that option. You can find this option over here where you can able to filter by data sets and data marts, right? So this is your data hub feature, so that you can manage your users can find data sets and data marts side by side, filter and search to find data they need, and they can create a report. So apart from that, data hubs, there are a lot of features added in the embedded analytics. If you can see here, this is one of the important feature where if you are using the paginated reports in embedding, then single sign-on is not working earlier. Now they enabled it. So support embedding paginated reports with data sources containing single sign-on. So these are very important things that I have missed, and now they are fixing it. So direct query for Power BI datasets is now supported in Power BI embedded. So some of the reasons people has to switch between embedding or export, different options, because certain features are not supported in this, right? So now they are fixing all those things. So we, in order to decide which one to choose, what methodology you are going, whether you are sharing your report to users or embedding, and what are the data sources, all these things you need to consider. For that, you need to keep checking this updates every time, every month, so that when the requirement comes, you can able to catch up and give you the solution. And that's all about the major updates. There are not much of the things that we general audience is interested in. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.